So, you know, our sort of pragmatic approach to this is to remember that, you know, as you think about what these pieces are, that the data governance is creating best practices that helps people access, understand, connect, and effectively use your institution's data across all systems. So the important thing about this is this helps people concept here. So we're, you know, we're not creating a folder that gets put on a shelf that defines your policies and rules and structure in your dictionary. It, everything that you're trying to do with governance is around trying to help people, you know, to access, understand, connect, and effectively use your institution's data across all systems, which I would assume is being hindered by one of these problems, right? So one of these problems that you've defined, you know, people don't know where the data is, or they can't connect, or they don't understand it. Like those things are, you know, you want to implement these best practices of governance to help that, right? So that'll help you prioritize. The other thing to think about as you're trying to set your goals and decide what processes to implement around governance is to understand that governance is not about control, right? It's about sort of understanding and helping. So the goal is not to stop people from doing things. Now, that used to be, I think, how most people think about it. And frankly, if you're coming at it from sort of a security and access issue, that may be what you're, you know, what's happening. But actually, it really shouldn't, because one of the times the things about security and access is that uncertainty about security and access, I think, more commonly breeds lack of activity than sort of, you know, overactivity that might be in violation of that. So, you know, if there's clearly defined and understood processes and policies and information about security and access, I think, you know, people then know that they feel more free to go take the actions that they're entitled to, right? So, when you talk about things like definitions and specifications and all that, it should really be helping people do stuff. So you also want to think about that in terms of, you know, not trying to, at least out of the gates, you know, implement a bunch of processes and things and you know, rules and bureaucratic steps that actually end up stopping people from doing it. So it even if the stop comes just from, you know, having to climb a mountain before they can, you know, write a report or something or request the data, that's a something you have to think about. So the goal is to give the necessary information and actionable processes to do things correctly and appropriately. So if your data governance is stopping people from doing their job effectively, it will fail. So you want to have sort of a clear path forward, and the governance needs to support that. So these are just, you know, these sort of things to think about as you create your governance processes to make sure, are we facilitating helping people, or is we facilitating action as opposed to stopping action, right? And are we solving the problems that we've defined that are the reason we're doing governance?